entire semester, we focus a great deal on body language and emotion and how to portray that realistically. They've pretty much mastered it at this point. They're very good at it. We're going to present a little skit for you in a few minutes. And we go through a variety of different emotions. So girls, what are some of the emotions that we go through in our skit? Guilt? Can you show me your guilty looks? Very good. What other emotions do we go through during the skit?
Bored.
Boredom. Can you show me bored? So
excited.
Excited. Show me excited. Good. What other emotions do we feel? What happens when something? What is it called? What is that emotion called?
Shocked.
Show me shocked. Good. We also experience a little bit of a mischievous feeling. Show me mischievous. Show me that smirk. That smile. Yeah. So during our skit, see if you can kind of point out those emotions. They've worked very hard on them, as well as the body language. So along with working on all this stuff, we've had our discussions all throughout. So Adeline, what's another thing that you learned during our discussions? How did you get such a beautiful heart? What did you do to get such a big, beautiful heart? You're very nice and kind to people, aren't you? All the time, Addie. This little girl goes out of her way to make people feel included and welcome and just encourages them. She's incredible. You should be so proud of her. Elle, what's one thing that you learned in our discussions?
Stand up for yourself.
Stand up for yourself, attagirl. When you're standing up for yourself, Elle, can you have very shy body language? What do you think?
No.
No. Show me what kind of body language you should have. Yeah, confident. That's my girl. And should you use your soft, shy voice or your more powerful voice when you're standing up for yourself?
Powerful.
That is right. Very, very good. Well, girls, do you think we're ready to show off our scene?
Yeah.
Please go backstage.